everyone, Draco Magnus here for another episode. Let's play Dragon Quest VIII Journey of the Cursed King. In the last episode, we came through the Dark Eye into the Dark World, or as I'm calling it now, the Monochrome World. And as you can see, I'm holding a vase. I accidentally picked it up when I tried to leave. So I have a question for you guys. What time is it? Yes, once again, it is looting time. We're starting with this pot, because it got in the way. Nothing. Alright, now let's open this chest to see what's in it. A special antidote. Oh, I get it, because wasn't there a special medicine in there last time? In the reverse? Ooh, 1800 gold. I like that. Now, before we continue, let's ask Yangus what's in this town. Oh, Yangus, what does your nose for treasure say about this place? By the smell of it, there's 11 treasures around here somewhere, Gov. Thank you. Cowpat? Why is that horse lying on the ground like that? Huh. Okay. Piece of cold cheese. I think that was the same thing that was there in the light world. Ooh, hey, a mini metal! Nothing. Doing good so far. It's just like inverted version of the last time. With slightly new treasures, I suppose, in theory. Well, anyway, it seems that fire and water are the only thing of color in this world. Which is fairly interesting. I mean, I get fire because it is light in itself, but I don't understand why water would have color. And another mini metal, by the way. So that means between Empycchu and Dark Empycchu, you should get 6 mini metals in total, correct? Oh yeah, in theory. And yes, I want to go. I don't remember this house from the last Empycchu. Oh no, wait, this was the house filled with children. Now I remember it. Ah, and I like that touch. In the light world, all the children were standing around the fire. In this world, they're sitting around it, since sitting is the opposite of standing, and this is the dark world, which is the opposite of the light world. Nice touch. A lot of reverse images. And some that are just completely off, like this one. I believe the woman was standing in front of a clothesline, and this one there is no clothesline. It's just all over the ground, I guess. Pretty sure that, and the three pots were on the other side, weren't they? Or is that just one I made myself? Premium mold! Oh, baby! Okay, now. Let's see what Yangus says now. How many treasures, Yangus, my man? 3 more. So then the rest are in here. And then we're done with our looting time and we can continue with story. Meh. I like looting better. Dragon scale, nice. Oh, another mini metal. Well then, I guess there's a total of 7 mini metals between Empycchu and Dark Empycchu. Okay, now with that, let's talk to the chief here.
Gushar, welcome to Empycchu. You've seen our village, yes? Then let me tell you something. I assume the others have told you that Empyrea was responsible for the attack on our village.
Oh, I didn't know. I didn't talk to anyone, I just looted.
It is natural to think this, but to be honest, I am not fully convinced that she wished to cause us any harm. Since times of old, Empyrea has been venerated by the people of Empycchu. It was not simply because she was pretty. It was because she has protected us. I beg of you, will you find out why Empyrea continues to attack us? I believe there's some hidden meaning behind her actions. I also believe that your arrival here is not an accident. I believe it to be fate. Only Empyrea may cross between the world of darkness and the world of light. It was she who guided you here, correct? Then Empyrea must be thinking something. She may reveal the truth to you. I apologize for putting such a burden on your shoulders. But if nothing is done, I will not be able to stop the people of Empycchu from attacking Empyrea. A war with Empyrea would only lead to tragedy. I kind of made him German there by mistake. This is why I want you to find out why the Godbird is attacking us. Will you accept my request? Yes. So you will do it? I thank you. And now I shall tell you how to find Empyrea. She is often seen near Empyrea's roost, a large rock formation in a nearby field. I suggest looking for her there first. Okay. One problem, in the light world I tried getting there and I couldn't find jack diddly poop over in that direction that I could get to. Oh well. I already smashed that. Well then I guess we're going to Empyrea's roost. Excuse me, pardon me, come through. Got a godbird to find and ask questions. That's gonna be really, really awkward. Asking a bird questions, especially if it doesn't know English. Because if it's a bird that doesn't know English, it'll just go, ah! And I'm supposed to know what that means? I probably should have rested at the inn first, but it doesn't seem like there's a night and day in the dark world. Since it's all monochrome and stuff. Alright, I guess we're going this way. Perhaps I should use holy protection. Okay, now let's continue. I'm assuming this is Empyrea's roost over that way. Wait, do I see? I thought I saw a path, but I don't. Okay. Now, gotta figure out how one gets up there. Wait, is that a side path over there? If so, I'm really, really lucky. I just learned Darkodiles can damage the entire party by jumping on them from above, and nope, this is not a way up there. It doesn't look like there's any way I could possibly get up there. There might be a way. I think I see it on the map. There's like a side path or something. But how would I get down there? Unless... Oh, that's a very roundabout way. And it might not even end up well. That's still my only hope, though. Fine. I'm just gonna keep following this, I guess, until I get to a point where I can go around. Damn it. What a drag. And another new enemy, Dark Sea Diva. So that's 7 new enemies that we've seen so far. What's with all of these new enemies? Well, I guess it's because this is the Dark World, and there's only one area you can find Dark World enemies, and that would be in the Dark World. Yeah, that makes sense. If I get stuck at some point, I'm just gonna consult the guide again, because I really can't think of any way I can get past this. Oh, we need some health. Well, at least Jessica and Yangus do. And then there was one. Okay. Alright then. I should probably full heal. Okay.
Where am I? You're kidding me. I can't... Okay. I can't see any way of getting up there, so... I'm gonna have to consult the strategy guide. I'll see you guys in a few seconds, I guess. Okay, guys, I'm back, and as you can see, I'm here at Empycchu. Two things. One, in the Dark World, we can only fly back to Dark Empycchu after visiting it. And two, the thing they were talking about was not that cliff over there. It is the archway that was in the Light World, but this time in the Dark World. Oh, jeez. But I'm going to go and side Empycchu and heal. Yeah. And also, the archway is to the south of Empycchu in this world, I guess. That's what the guide says. So it's probably like south, east, or west or something like that. Although I can just look at the map and figure that out, probably, right? Yeah, probably. World of Life, tired visit. There's a hole in the roof, but please, why don't you stay the night? Yeah, sure. I don't mind. Whatever. Okay, now let's get going to that archway or something. Alright. Shame we don't have Ultras the Ultra Slime to help us because my slimes were acting dumb as hell. Tis a great shame. Okay, open the map. Okay, so I want to go southwest. I believe that's the direction we want it to head in. Hope I didn't say that too early, because that's going to make it really awkward to cut this. There it is. Okay, I was kind of right? Damn it! Like hell it ran out! There. Stupid effing trees getting in my way. I'm trying to get to friggin' archway here. And cutscenes. Huh, what was that? It was blue. Oh, this must be Empycchu. Holy crap, get out of there! Oh, we're fighting it. That's very pretty. Wait. We're fighting something that is essentially a god. I have nothing but positive projections for the outcome of this battle. Seriously, nothing but positive things. I am going to die horribly. Any particular reason you attacked us? Oh, I'm not... Empycchu isn't its name. Empyrea. Whoops, that was the name of the town. I don't know why I was thinking Empycchu. Whoops. Ah! Is this a fight we just can't win, or... Or are we just really unlucky, or something? Kazing, please! I know I did keep the strategy guide up. I could look to see if it has any insight on this battle. Oh no! Not anything but dazzled! Okay. Okay, apparently the way this fight is going to work is... Empyrea has immensely high defense, however, her health isn't that high. But this is still probably going to be a pretty lengthy battle, or at least that's what the strategy guide told me. Mid-heal on Yangus, I guess? I don't think... Did she use oomph yet? She might have when I wasn't looking. Oh, this bird is a bitch. She has the spell zap, the spell mid-heal. And that's all I really need to say. So we should probably buff our magic defense. I mean, most damage she does is from her physical, but I'm still doing it. I don't care. And then I'll have Yangus do to buff, I guess. Friggin' bitch bird. Does Angelo also have kabuff? Actually, no, he needs to heal Gillian next turn, so I'll have Yangus do it. Oh, but he seems to be doing the most damage. Yeah, we'll just ignore it for now, I guess. Bounce as well. And full heal Gillian. Please don't kill him! He's dead.
Mercy.
And what's worse is now we have no healer. I'm gonna have to waste my turn using the Angel Cheese. And none of us... Well, I have heal spells, so... Yeah, Yangus seems to be the biggest threat to Empyrea. Angel Cheese, please. If that brings back all party members, that would just be kind of annoying. Oomph. You know what? Yeah, let's oomph Yangus. Take the cheese! Oh, fuck me. It's just standard zing. The angel cheese. You bitch bird. Fuck. We're kinda boned now. Actually, not kinda boned. This is straight up boned with no possible chance of victory kind of boned. Please work. Yep, we're boned. I honestly don't see any possible way for us to win this battle anymore. Yep. Only one left is me. And I'm having low health for my character. And everyone is dead. And we still have full magic, just this bird is a colossal bitch. Oh, finally! Now I think it's just gonna be me and Angelo zinging everyone for the rest of the... Motherfuck! You stupid fucking bird! I just brought him back, bitch! Please work. Oh, thank God. Why do you keep attacking him? How could you keep attacking him? Fuck you, you stupid fucking bird. Does this mean I go back to the light world? Because that's the last place I saved, and that's not even on Empycchu. Where did I save last time? No. Seriously, the Savella Cathedral? Like... Okay. Fine. That's how the stupid bitch bird wants to play it. We'll play that way. Fine. Although, in this case, I can use Ultras the Ultra Slime now. We can probably rape her if it goes first. Let's go to the alchemy pot. What was I making? The fire boomerang, right? Yes. That's what I was making. The flame tang boomerang. I just realized that rhymes. I wonder how strong that is compared to the... not very strong compared to that. Okay. Now, what was the next one I was going to make? It's the one with the bastard sword, right? Yep. Bastard sword. Where's the cold cheese? There you are. Cold cheese. And the icicle dirk will make the blizzard blade. I'm obviously gonna have to train off-screen, which is what annoys me more, because I just stopped from training off-screen. What a mess. I guess I'll go back to Empycchu using Zoom, then I'll save and dark Empycchu and grind from there. The only issue being I don't know if I'll be able to finish the battle off in here. Well, I'll let you know in the next part, but I'm gonna cut this here and start training. See you guys then. Oh wait, actually, yeah, I'll bring back Ultras and then I'll see you guys. Okay guys, I'm back. I did not grind, but instead off screen I decided to go to the monster arena and do the B rank. I managed to win. I was going to do the A rank, but I lost three times because Ultras, or the three slimes, are idiots. In one round, the first time I did the A rank, on the very last round they decided not to fuse into Ultras for some reason and all of them got killed. The second attempt I got to round two, and they refused to transform into Ultras and all got killed. The third time I tried making Ultras, and they didn't do it in the first round. The fourth time, they made it all the way to the end again and decided not to form Ultras. But because I won rank B, I got two things. I got Yangus a new scythe called the Birdacre Binding, which is an enchanted weapon that can deprive its target the ability to cast spells. And I have the ability to have two monster teams at once, so I'm going to summon both Drasubius and Ultras in battle. Oh, right. Also, I looked up a strategy on how to beat Empyrea, which is... stupid fucking trees and slimes. By the way, dark slimes, no frizzle, apparently. So yeah, that's a thing. Anyway. I lost my train of thought because of those stupid effing random encounters. There it is. Anyway, I found the a strategy to beat Empyrea. So I'm gonna try utilizing that. Anyway, let's just move on, and I'll probably cut the cutscene again if it appears, which it probably will, unless something new happens for some reason. Okay, what the strategy guide suggests you do is you psych up both Gillian and Yangus, but have them exchange. So for right now, I'm going to buff Gillian to 20 psych up, because that's where it suggests to attack. Then after he attacks, I'm going to have Yangus psych up and then attack to cycle it. And he's going to use... let's go for Grim Reaper. And Jessica and Angelo, you just have regular attack unless Angelo needs to heal. So, let's see, what am I gonna... Also, another interesting strategy you could use is if you get Kafrizzle, which is what I'm going to attempt next, by the way, if this doesn't work. If Jessica gets the spell Kafrizzle, psych her up four times and then use it, and you can instant KO Empyrea. But for now, we're just gonna go and try and kill the birdie with our regular methods. Okay. Oh crap, it used that. Oh wait, that's right, I was supposed to put Magic Barrier up too. Crap. Okay. I need some health. Let's see, that was at 5. Actually, you know what? I'll try regular attack just to see how that works out for me. Let's pop up a magic barrier. Angela will use full heal. Then after magic barrier, she'll use bounce, because that's also going to be helpful. Okay. Seems about the same, only with Grim Reaper having an added effect. Crap baskets. Now Angelo and Yangus need health. Wait, what was his psych up last... that last bit? 10? Yeah, because I only used it twice. Wonder how much damage that'll do. Okay, now let's use Bounce. And Angelo... No. Multi-heal. Oh, crap! I was supposed to get to 20 and then just use it. Not 50. Granted, this will do more damage and all, but it says 20 and just keep going like that. That was a mistake on my part, and I feel bad about that. Okay. Oh, really? You cast Zap, huh? Ha! Take that, Empyrea! You think you're boss, but you ain't boss. Okay, I'm using Windsickle for now, because that's a lot better. Alright, I'm going to have Angelo use Multi-Heal again. And Gillian will use Falcon Strike as it attacks twice, while Yangus continues psyching up. Jessica is the barrier and the magic up, so... Let's also oomph Gillian, and Angelo will use Multi-Heal again or Full Heal. He's fine for now, I guess, so yeah, let's Full Heal. Unless Empyrea decides to attack him. Okay, now hopefully I go in. Yes! Excellent! Very excellent. Ow, don't hit Jessica like that. Who do you think you are, Empyrea? At least she's not taking damage here. And since she has Bounce, she can't take a heal spell, so she's gonna have to spend her turn healing herself. With Caduceus. Which is fine, I suppose. That's in abilities. And Angelo, you go and heal yourself. Kim, yeah, I'm pretty optimistic about this strategy, actually. And that looked very painful. And it's gonna kill me now. Yep. Oh, good, and Angelo's almost dead, too. Because, you know, couldn't get any better. Although, I could have Jessica use her revive staff. Angelo already healed himself, so... See, he needs to heal Jessica now, but Jessica can only heal herself. Alright, Angelo's using Kazing, then. And you are using Caduceus again on yourself. Angelo will be using a Kazing on Gillian. Okay. Oh yeah! Okay. As long as she doesn't attack Jessica, Empyrea, we should be fine. Crap. It used Dazzle and everyone was dazzled. Ah, take that, stupid bird. I did it again. I got him to 50 by mistake. Oh, hey, Yangus wasn't dazzled. That's excellent, actually. Alright, so now it's his turn. He'll use Windsickle. Jessica's now good, so let's oomph Yangus. Okay. We'll heal Yangus. It's a good thing he's the only one that's really attacking aside from me. Shame that my attack did nothing there. And then Jessica had to die. And that she's the only one that had a bounce on. And now that I think about it, Angelo also has bounce, so on his turn, when he has nothing to do, I should do that. Ah, crap, and the magic barrier just went down. As if today could not get any worse for anyone. What do I want to do? He doesn't have anything magically, so I guess I'll just continue with... No, wait, he's supposed to be psyching up this turn. Yangus, however, is not, and Angela will be once again bringing someone back to life from the dead. Oh. I'd be more annoyed at that, but on the plus side, since she used mid-heal, she's not really using any actual attacks, even though she did use one. Still, though. Also, we can make her take 93 damage again. Oh, wait, am I no longer dazzled? That's fantastic. Okay, now. Wait, Yangus just attacked her? That's right, so I'm the one who's doing stuff. And then Jessica shall use... No. You're using magic barrier. Angelo needs to fully heal Yangus so he doesn't go down. And then next turn he'll use bounce. And I'll also have Jessica use bounce just to be safe. And now Jessica's dead, so never mind. Okay, I'm at 20. So now I should attack. And look, she's already lost more than the 90 that she lost. Okay. No, wait, yeah, I'm supposed to be. Right. Okay, then that means Yangus' turn to psych. This is very repetitive and annoying at this point. Okay, everyone has a magic barrier except Jessica now, so I'll have her use bounce on her next turn. F. U. Empyrea. Okay. On the plus side, Yangus is still doing it. He's the only one who didn't lose any... Well, actually, he kind of did. Now, magic barrier again. Is everyone good on health? Everyone except Angelo. And then, once everyone is fine, he's going to use bounce so someone has a bounce up. Stop dying, Jessica! Seriously, it's getting annoying. At least Zap doesn't do that much damage anyway. Okay, now Yangus is ready to go. So this turn I psych. He uses Windsickle. Zing again. Okay. F this. Now I still need to do it. At least he used mid-heal, which is fairly easy to deal with. Fuck you, you stupid bird. I hate this stupid bird. You better be worth all the trouble you put us through. I forget which one was which, so I'm just gonna do that. Magic barrier. Oh! Is Angela finally free to do something this turn? Where's bounce? Stupid effing bird. Oh, she had bounce! Either that or she has an automatic bounce on from something that I'm not exactly sure, but whatever. Maybe it's an item she's holding. That's possible. Like the Staff of Resurrection, or maybe it's the magic, mace that does it. Now we have two bounces, technically, if that always works, which it might not all the time. Okay, now you psych. You wind. You oomph. And you heal. Oh wait, I forgot to summon my monster teams. I'll do that next round then. Yeah, I think what I'll do is I'll... Oh good, she's still alive. Fuck you, you stupid bird. Okay. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm calling in Drasuvius first. Well, actually, wait. Jessica's pretty low on health. Now let's summon Unstoppable. Even though they're stoppable if they don't go first and form Ultras! You hear me? You hear me, slimes? Apparently they didn't, because they didn't form a fucking Ultras! Since this bird can attack what? Yep, this was pointless. Thank you for the pointless, stupid, and damn it, I accidentally hit attack. They're all gonna die. Well, one of them survived, but that really doesn't help! You're damn right you fled, because that was pointless! Why can't they be useful in outside of battle? This is supposed to be the strongest team ever, and they suck! Drasuvius, please cover some of the slack that was just created because Unstoppable is a stupid team. Not that doing much better, but at least it's doing something. Oh my god, they took her out. Oh, I didn't have to do the Kefrizzle strategy. Whoa, that's a lot of experience. Hooray, levels! I still have that skill seed, don't I, that I never used. Should probably take care of that. Scything clubs? Yeah. Actually, that evens it out, so yeah. Seed of Magic. Anyway.
You are brave to have followed my shadow here from the world of light.
Oh my god, it speaks.
And you are able fighters.
Yeah.
Perhaps you have realized already, but that battle was a test.
Oh, a test, huh?
Please forgive my methods, but I am in search of someone strong to help me.
Okay.
What do you mean? Surely you don't expect us to help you attack the village? I'm afraid you've misjudged us. We're not about to help you with your... scheme?
Well, you don't know that that was her.
Please do not misunderstand me. It was never my desire to attack the village.
And why'd you do it if you did?
That too is part of the reason why I am in need of help.
What, do you have something evil living inside you or something?
When Rapthor, Lord of Darkness, attempted to conquer the world of light, I helped the sages to seal him away.
But this is the part of the story we already know.
In so doing, I earned the enmity of the monstrous servants of Rapthor. That is why I am in this predicament. I have a baby.
Oh.
An egg in my nest. I have been waiting for the day it would hatch. But my nest has been captured by Gemon, one of Ratthorn's foul minions.
What a dick.
He is holding my egg hostage. He forced me to attack the human village. I could not refuse if I wanted to save my child.
What an ass! My god, abducting a child!
I would have nothing to fear from the likes of Gevon. But as long as he has my egg, I am powerless to oppose him.
Oh, poor Empyrea.
That is why I must find someone to fight him in my place.
As long as he's weaker than you.
Someone brave and strong. You did not waver in following my shadow here to the world of darkness. Such bravery is rare.
Really?
And now you have proven your strength in battle. I have no doubt that you are the only ones brave enough and strong enough to defeat Gemon.
Yay!
Please help me. Save my egg. For me, for my unborn child, and for the people of this island.
Okay, but how are we gonna get to Gemon?
Thank you. I was right to choose you. My nest is on a precipice at the summit of a mountain, far beyond the reach of humans.
Okay, so how are we getting there?
Watching for me, so I cannot take you all the way to the top, but I can take you to the mountain's base.
Well, I guess that's fair.
Are you ready to go now?
Sure.
Then I will take you. All of you, climb into the wagon or hold on tight.
I guess Unstoppable isn't going to be making an appearance in the fight against Gemon. Oh my! How did Jessica get inside the wagon? Well, at least we beat her.
This is as far as I can take you. I dare not approach any closer, lest Gemon see me.
All right.
But the mountain is riddled with caves. It should be possible for you humans to ascend to its summit on foot.
I see.
When you wish to return to the hill, call for me, and I will take you back. Farewell for now. Please save my egg. You are my only hope.
All right then, Empyrea. But with that, I think we're going to end this episode here. So next episode, Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII, Journey of the Cursed King. We'll go try and save Empyrea's egg from the despiteful Gemon. See you guys then.